Why are addicts demonized, but there's sympathy for celebrities? Because I'm unlikely to have my car broken into for valuables by Tom Cruise. Society is not a hive mind. Some people criticize addicts, some have sympathy. Celebrities just have better moderators. I think the big difference is that celebrities, or at least, rich people don't steal your stuff in order to finance their drug addiction. I think most people can sympathize with the struggles each of them must be going through. But if your home is broken into for the umpteenth time by a drug addict, I think it's only natural that your sympathy for that person falls dramatically. His struggle is now causing your struggle. But I get what you're saying. The struggle for a poor non-celebrity addict is just as great, if not greater, than that of a celebrity. It's just that the celebrity's struggle just doesn't impact you negatively. Anyway, that's just my two cents on the reason. I went to rehab, my friends embraced me when I got out. You relapse, it's not like that. Get away from me, that's what it's like. Quote from West Wing. It could be that in some distant way we witnessed the process, knew them before they became addicted, and noticed the changes. That might inspire a bit more empathy, maybe? I understand that completely, but also understand that these people are doing this to fund their addictions. I've heard it said and seen that it feels like you're dying when in the throes of withdrawal, and I'm sure most, if not all of us, would do anything possible to stop that feeling. I get that having your stuff stolen and the negative connotations impact their lives, but it's the double standard on addiction that I feel impact these people further, and if anything pushes them further into the spiral of addiction. If no one cares about me anyway, why should I? Because they are pretty. Would they be paid for this? Where is this? Fame and ego is hell of a drug. I guess there really isn't much difference, both our industry at the end of the day. To me, the better question is, why do most families relate with addiction? Almost all of us have a friend or relative who deals with substance use issues or is in recovery from it, yet we still choose to stigmatize it. The stigma only reinforces it and we all lose. It's unfortunate and unnecessary. There isn't always sympathy. Demi Lovato has been made fun of every day since her OD. Usually the sympathy comes after they died. I would argue that celebrities who are addicts are also demonized and looked down on. Look at Lindsay Lohan, for example. Her career was essentially ruined for years because of drug addiction. People had no sympathy for her. People don't like addicts in any form. I will also point out that his celebrity addict hurts no one but themselves. They are wealthy enough to care for their family. They aren't on welfare taking taxpayer money that could be used for other things, and they aren't breaking into cars and houses to try and fund their addiction. It's not a double standard because it has completely different outcomes impacts. Looks, an addict looking neat is always better perceived than a beggar who never touched drugs. Since you work with people in addiction, you know that many have burned bridges with friends, families, and even communities. Maybe they stole money, betrayed a loved one, lied to hide or support their addiction, stayed on the couch too long, damaged someone else's property. Celebrities usually have money and are a safe distance from their admirers. Money insulates many problems. A rich person in addiction can crash their own car, not their mom's. They can use their own money to support their addiction. They can hire people to enable them. Addiction hurts people and families no matter the income level. Still, money makes the damage to other people less direct. I've never demonized an addict, and it's probably because I come from a family that has lost 3 people to addiction problems and also have 2 family members who managed to beat their addiction, or at least control it. My guess is people who shit all over addicts have never had a family member suffer. A good friend of mine used to shit all over people with addiction problems, and then she married a guy who liked cocaine. As she told me, he only does it at parties. Right. Fast forward a few years, and she's working multiple jobs to support her family because the husband just lays around waiting for his next high. Eventually, the guy died after doing some cocaine mixed with fentanyl. Now she is all people who never lived with an addict don't understand. Yeah. No shit. If you're rich, you have a drinking problem, and if you're poor, you're a drunk. Because generally the celebrities are still accomplishing great things in life while on that drug. Meanwhile, most addicts basically give up on life. There isn't, they got tons of hate too.